Hi, welcome back to the Horizon's Edge channel featuring profiles from the Titanic. It's great to be with you once again, and this is a very special video that I'm doing here today, putting it together. And I know you may not watch it on this very day, but it'll be on YouTube hopefully for a long time. But I am producing and putting this video up on YouTube on April 15th, and this is a very special day, of course, in the Titanic community. It is Titanic Remembrance Day, or otherwise known as the 109th anniversary of the sinking of the Titanic. And it was, of course, 109 years ago, early this morning. And it's a very emotional day, very special day in the Titanic community when we remember those who lost their lives on the North Atlantic waters that morning. And that's what this YouTube channel is all about. And I strongly encourage you also to, you know, support other YouTube channels. There's some really good ones out there. Last night, for example, I watched the Titanic 109 anniversary, the live animation and anniversary of the sinking. It's really cool. If you've never seen that or haven't participated in one of those, just search on YouTube, punch in like Titanic 109, and you'll get it. It's a really cool thing. Literally, with the computer graphics, exactly as it would have looked like 109 years ago, and a team of experts commenting literally minute by minute as you go along. It's one of the really cool experiences of the Titanic community to get to kind of relive that and see what was happening as time went on, from the time it struck the iceberg to even well after the Titanic sank on the morning of April 15th. So another thing you can also do, great folks over at Titanic Historical Society. I joined that society last year. A lot of great cutting edge information, new articles and research on Titanic and other things of dealing with the ocean and shipping and all of that. It's a really great society. Some of the top experts in Titanic research, Don Lynch and Park Stevenson and these guys, you see them a lot on the Titanic documentaries. They are members of the Titanic Historical Society, so I joined that as well, and it's great to keep that alive. And like I said, cutting-edge research into the Titanic that is still going on today. So enough of that. Let's get to the profile today. We're back to the third-class register here, and today we're going to take a look at actually a couple of young men, but we're going to focus on one of them. They were two young men who were coming to the United States to do some boxing. That's right. We don't normally hear too much about the third class passengers. Most of the officers, the crew, first and second class passengers, we know a lot about their names and so forth. This is one you might not have heard about these couple of young men who were coming to engage in some sports and do some boxing matches in the United States. And so today, the young man's name is Leslie Williams and his friend Di Bowen from England. And we will profile them on Profiles from the Titanic today. Make sure you hit the subscribe and the like button so I can keep doing these little profiles and bringing you the people who were on board the Titanic, who we still think about and remember even 109 years later. So hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching. Leslie Williams was born in Tony Pandy, Wales in 1888. As a young man, he was an apprentice to a boilermaker, and by 1910, he married and had a son born later that year. Along the way, Leslie got involved in the sport of boxing, and when a boxing promoter in America offered a good sum of money to come to the United States for a year-long contract, Williams and another young boxer by the name of Di Bowen were selected for the lucrative trip. They were originally scheduled to leave on the Lusitania the week before, but seeing that the two young men could not be ready in time because they were waiting on new tailored suits to be finished, they booked third-class passage on the new steamer, the RMS Titanic, which left a few days later. They promised to make good use of the gym on board the ship, so they would be ready to box once they landed in America. Williams had at least 10 boxing matches under his belt, and Bowen had 6. They were considered to be promising up-and-coming fighters in the bantamweight class. On the night of Sunday, April 14th, the Titanic struck the iceberg and began her slow demise. While not much is known about the actions of Williams or Bowen that night, both young men perished in the freezing waters of the North Atlantic. With a water temperature of 28 degrees, most people perished within 10 to 15 minutes, either of hypothermia or cardiac arrest due to the shock. Di Bowen's body was never found, but the recovery ship Mackay Bennett did manage to pull aboard Leslie Williams' body. He was buried at sea on April 22nd. His wife Lily was 6 months pregnant at the time.
and she gave birth to another son in late July named Harold. William's first son, Leslie Jr., died in an accidental coal mining explosion in 1965 at age 54. The younger son, Harold, died just 6 years later at age 59 in 1971. Aunt Lily outlived them all. She remarried and had a large family before she passed away at the age of 90 in 1981. Thanks for watching Profiles from the Titanic.